Respected and dear children of the mother, the questions I have received from here is, the first question, what is the role of psychic being in order to lead the sadhak of this yoga to evolve their sadhana? First of all, what is the role? I have collected, because many of sadhaks questioned Mother and Sri Aurobindo about the role, I have collected few points that will be helpful for us. First thing Mother says, that this, since this yoga starts with surrender and ends in surrender, the psychic alone knows how to surrender unconditionally. Our mind can surrender, but full of conditions, its own way, preconceived ideas, all these things have to be fulfilled in order to surrender. And vital, it has ambitions, it has desires. So it also puts condition to the divine. If you do this, if you fulfill this, then only I will surrender. That is not real surrender. Surrender means unconditional. So the psychic alone knows how to surrender unconditionally. That is the main role of psychic being in our sadhana, because sadhana is impossible unless we surrender really. We all say that we are surrendering, but actually we are not surrendering. We are fulfilling our desires through the divine. That is not the surrender. Surrender means whatever happens, apparently bad or good, but if she wants, that is prasada for us, that is blessing for us. So if this attitude is developed, it is only possible through psychic. And when psychic and when mind and vital and body is influenced by the psychic, that is called psychicization, then only mind also can surrender unconditionally, vital also can surrender unconditionally, and physical also will surrender unconditionally. Once they start surrendering, then the true sadhana begins, and it becomes so powerful. Without these instruments, the surrender sense is there with the psychic, but it cannot be powerful. Suppose you have started your institution, she is organizing, no problem. But if instruments are not collaborating, then it cannot be done. Similarly, psychic has that quality of surrender. But how it will be manifested? It will be manifested through its instruments, through its staff, that is mind, vital and body. So without psychic, mind, vital and body cannot do sadhana. But without these instruments, psychic also cannot manifest itself. So both are very important. Psychic plays a greater role to link our external being with the divine. Mother says it acts like a wire, electric wire. If we are, our outer life is a bulb and divine is a generator, then it connects. Without wire, generator is useless as far as from the point of view of manifestation. And bulb is also useless because it will not give light. So psychic has a central role in our sadhana.
Just for the benefit of all, some of the new teachers, just a small definition of the psychic being.
Yes, I will. Because you have not asked, I presumed that you all know about it. Definitely, I will tell. What is psychic? Actually, there is only one truth, that is we call Brahman or Supreme. There is only one existence. But it has the nature of expansion. So it only expands in various ways. It multiplies itself. Previously, this multiplication was called Mithya. Only Brahma Satya, Jagat Mithya. Jagat means multiplication of himself. Previously, everybody used to tell that this multiplication is Mithya, false, and alone he is truth. But Sri Aurobindo says, how can multiplication will be false if it has come from it? That is what his argument. If Brahman is truth, anything comes out of Brahman must be true. Suppose if I am a human being, if I give birth, he also will be a human being. He will be like me. So if whole creation is coming out of him, it must be real, if Brahman is real. So this multiplication is his expression, his manifestation. Why he manifested? Because it was within him, no other reason. If something is within the seed, it has to manifest. If I have inside a feeling of singing, I cannot remain without singing. If he is doing art, he has an impulse of doing artwork, he cannot remain without doing that, because it is within. There are no other reason for this, for that, and divine has manifested, all these things are nonsense. The very thing is that it is his, within him. These potentialities were within him. That has come out. That we call as manifestation. That's all. So this multiplication is also he. But he has all possibilities. We have our unique possibilities. That is the difference. I express him. You express him. But you express in your own way. He expresses his own way. Everybody will express him only, nothing else. Now we are under training, that is why we are not beautifully expressing him with so many deformations. But ultimately, we will express him uniquely. That unique expression is called psychic being. That unique in term of potentiality is our soul. Soul is within us. But it has not yet expressed through mind, vital and body, because they are not ready yet. When that uniqueness will be expressed, the uniqueness in the soul will be expressed through mind, vital and physical, that personality, it has developed a personality. Psychic being is known as personality of the soul. Personality of the soul means, suppose I am new to this place. You do not know me. If I will ask you 1,000 rupees, you will say, who are you? You do not know. You cannot. That means I have not established my personality over here. Okay. If I visit 10 times or 20 times here with Chaladidi, and if I will ask you for 1,000 rupees, you will give me 5,000 rupees. Oh, we know that you will return back. We know about your personality. So this is called, when soul is coming to this world, aparajagat, that is mind, vital and physical. Slowly it is establishing its personality in the world of mind, vital and physical. That personality is known as psychic being. Not yet developed in us till now. It is under the process. Once it will be developed, mind will believe us, we believe the soul, vital will believe the soul, physical will also believe the soul, they will listen to him. Now they are not listening. Mind is in its own way, vital is in its own way, physical is in its own way, that is sitting there waiting for the opportunity when they will come and accept me. So psychic being is nothing but his original purpose, that is, he wants to manifest infinitely without any deformation. That infinite expression of the divine without any deformation, each of us represent one unique way of expression, that will be the psychic being. Supramental being is nothing but the psychic being is fully expressed. Divine has manifested in the psychic being in its totality, in its unique way. That is called psychic being. So that is what the main center point of Sri Aurobindo Yoga. Without psychic being, we cannot talk of Sri Aurobindo Yoga. So this psychic being prepares us. That is its role. That aim, it have to be fulfilled by mind, body and physical. These are not here to be rejected. Divine has to be fulfilled through this. That role psychic being will do. First role I have told you. Have you understood what psychic being is?
Psychic being, soul, self. Are they different or
synonymous? No.
Not from
one question. Yes. principle is same. Suppose you are in a home. Okay. You are called as father. And you have also work different from here. So you are the same. Principally you are the same. But there you are doing some other work, which is called father or something. Head of the home. Bringing vegetables from some places and doing all sort of work. Once you are coming here, you have a different name. She has introduced trustee, managing trustee, or like that. She has not introduced you as a father of that family or something. Here she has introduced as a managing trustee of this institution. You have a different role. But the person is same. And if you go to your friends, there you have a different role. If you go to government, you have a different role. So the role varies accordingly. The Supreme alone, only one, I told you, no, there is only one. When he is alone, beyond the time and space, but supporting everything, that is his role. That is called Supreme. When he expresses in terms of multiplicity, then we call Jivatma. When Jivatma is also beyond time and space, when it projects itself into the time and space, into our heart, the same thing. That is called Antaratma. When Antaratma develops its personality in our life, we call psychic being. It is only one, having multiple role, and according to the role, we give different name. Why would you give different name? Otherwise you cannot understand. Is it not? According to the role, we have to give the name. Why we are giving Narendra Modi as a Prime Minister? We understand, oh, his work is like that. If we simply say Narendra Modi, then Narendra Modi was also Chief Minister. He was doing different work. He was also a tea supplier. That is a different work. So, when I am identifying, I am giving a name, that means what is his role? I am identifying him with the role. That is why different names are given according to their function and role. But it is only one, that Supreme. Except Supreme, there are nobody. That is why once mother was asked, how many souls are there? Mother said, oh, only one. She must have gone through that writing. Because principally there is only one, only one. Only, she is only. She is only manifesting. Just like there is only one sea, but how many waves? But can wave say that I exist independent of sea? Let us bring one sea, wave here. Because beautiful land is there, only a sea wave is not available, no tide. So can we bring that? No, it cannot be different from the sea. Similarly, we cannot make ourselves different from the Supreme. It is the Supreme only manifesting differently. So second role is, I've told first role is surrender. Surrender is the important factor of our sadhana. Without surrender, you cannot think of Sri Aurobindo Yoga. Even tapasya is only for surrender. Whatever tapasya we do, make ourselves ready for surrender. That tapasya is also meant for surrender. Whatever effort we are doing, that is also for surrender. Nothing else. Second one, that while we are entering into the yoga, it appears so difficult because all aspects of life have to be accepted to us. Yet, not as it is, it has to be spiritualized. So it is very hard task. Previously, there was no difficulty because whatever not coming under spirituality, they used to reject. Okay, you go. Rejecting is very easy. That is also not easy, comparatively easy. Whatever is not fulfilling the condition, if we reject. But if they are not fulfilling condition, keeping them, giving training and making them prepared for the highest, it is a hard task. So we feel helpless when we enter into the yoga. We feel helpless. What? All the problems are entering into us. Previously it was not The more you enter into it, more problems will enter it, more challenges you have to face. So mother was told, mother, what problems are increasing day by day? Then once mother said that I never give any position to any sadhana. Positions are only for carry out the responsibility more. Not designation is not at all important. Designation itself proves that you have more responsibility. I never give any position to any sadhana. I give them work. Mother says, I give them work. Those who prove to be worthy of their work, I have a gift for them. Everybody thought mother will give something, gift. Everybody thought, I am doing very nice work, so mother will give some gift to me. Mother said, do you know what is the gift? To work more. So if you are sincere, be ready for more responsibility. That is the reward, nothing else. If you are not sincere, then slowly you will see that work is withdrawing from you. Slowly, situation will be like that. Work is withdrawing from you. So the more you are sincere, more mother will be pleased to give you more of her work. That great transformation work, you will also participate in that. That is the real meaning of life. Rather than that, I don't think, is there any meaning of life? I don't know. You might be knowing, but I don't know if there is any meaning of life without doing her work directly. Directly, her doing her work is only the meaning of life, our existence. If I exist, only for that. Otherwise, there is no meaning. So, we feel helpless. The moment psychic is awakened in us, then nothing will be difficult to achieve. Because we see the unseen hand of mother. Now we are not able to see. We feel that we are doing. No, I cannot do. I have been given so much. You are not doing. You are just an instrument. Some great force is doing through. Once monkeys were asked, you fool, you want to fight with Ravana? Do you know what he is taking in breakfast? 10 monkeys a day. Only in breakfast he is eating 10 monkeys. You want to fight with the Ravana? You all are fool. They said, we are not monkeys. Then who you are? We are Ram Sena. We are the army of Rama, the divine. Nobody can win us. If we are monkey, if we think monkey, then he will eat away. But we don't think that we are monkey. We are the soldiers of the Ram. Ram, that is divine. So similarly, once you recognize that it is all work, whatever we are doing, it is not we. We are doing. Externally, if there will be a camera and take video show, we all are doing. But internally, you must know. Previously, what happens? Starting of the Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna told Arjuna that you are working, you are free to work, but result I will give. Because at that time, if Sri Krishna would have been told that, no, you are not doing, I am doing, he would have left the job. You do, because ego is there, I am doing. But the last chapter, when Sri Krishna realized, Arjuna realized that actually I am not doing, he is within me, he is doing. At that time he declared that everything I am doing, you are only the instrument, nimitta matra. At last moment he told, that is the truth of us. As long as you have the ego, sense of ego, if mother will tell that I am doing, you are not doing, oh, what you are doing? Can you do if I will live? We think like that very often. Our ego never accepts that she is doing. Okay. Very often we say like that. That, oh, mother is doing, mother. But inside we feel that we are doing. But actual realization will come. Then everything becomes easy. the sadhana becomes easy because you see the touch of her, beautiful touch of her hand, that she can do everything. All can be done if God touches them. So this will happen when psychic comes forward. That is its role. It will make everything easy. Third role is, psychic being is the source of all food necessary for sadhana. What are the food necessary for sadhana? Aspiration, bhakti, love, rejection, power of rejection, willpower, all these things are restored in the psychic being. So once psychic being, we allow the psychic being to work out, all the instruments are with you to do sadhana. So many people asked mother that how to develop aspiration, how to have, how to develop bhakti, everything. Mother used to say one thing, concentrate within your psychic being, everything is there. It will just come out if you concentrate in the heart. So fourth thing is, psychic being gives us the power of discrimination. That is very much essential. Because this world at present is full of illusions. Good things are not appreciated. Bad things come in a beautiful form. Bad thing comes in a beautiful form, it will attract you. So you, very often you are under the deception, always. And you cannot know, because we recognize from outside, no? That is why people show themselves outside in order to be attracted. Because we are like that. We have no discriminating eye. Psychic being can distinguish between true and false. Because it never sees the outer form, it sees the vibration. Suppose you are here looking at me, but psychic being will know whether you are here or somewhere else. Whether you are remembering some of your friend or something going on within us, no? that it can see. It will not see the face, oh, beautifully she is looking to me. That means she is listening to me. Psychic will know actually what you are inside. So it will never, nobody will cheat it, can cheat it. Nobody. It knows very well. So it accepts the higher truth from the above and rejects the lower truth from the below. Till the transformation. Once the power of transformation comes, it accepts the lower and allows for the transformation. Till that it keeps it separate. Till that power of transformation comes to us. Whatever is not helpful for sadhana, it takes away. Keeps there. Not permanently takes away. When it gains the power for transformation, it will take again those things and everything has to be divinized. Fifth point is, psychic being receives the true things, psychic being makes our progress simple and easy. That is what I am telling. Progress, we always measure the things with result, no? Our effort is always painful. After getting the result, we are happy. Oh, after so much effort, we got this. But during the effort, we experience so many. But during the effort, you will experience the joy. That is very important. During the effort, we need not wait for the result. During the effort itself, you will experience the joy. That is the role of psychic being. Psychic being will make your life delightful. Every moment will make it delightful. A smiling attitude is its inherent quality. That is the special work of the psychic being, to receive the true things. You are right in the thinking that the psychic attitude is your true need. It is that which can make the progress simple, happy and easy. Sri Aurobindo. Then, seventh point. In the psychic atmosphere, the divine guidance work the best. I told you, know that the psychic is the instrument of the divine and our external being. Divine, if the divine wants to give any guidance, the best guidance he will give through psychic, not through mind, not through vital, because it will be perverted. Anything given is coming to us from direct from the divine. If it is to the mind, it is perverted in term of its own preconceived idea, in term of thoughts and everything. Everything is perverted. So these are the roles. I've told about psychic being main roles. Apart from that, there are also many roles.